This has been on YouTube, but I didn't see it through YouTube. I saw it from something else. And I'm not going to pronounce his last name because I don't know how to pronounce it. But his first name is Jing. So Jing was born in China, but then came over to the United States of America. And his goal in life was to make a successful company in the Fortune 500. So he had to be really successful. But he knew, as anyone I know, so he's been, so he had to be really smart.
No.
So he knew the only way he could make a company successful was to face his greatest fear. Okay? And he found out his greatest fear was rejection. I mean, nobody likes to be rejected, right? So he decided he would work his rejection like a muscle. So he was going to work it just like a muscle. So every day for 100 days, he was going to work his rejection. So he decided, I've got to be rejected for 100 days. So he started off by going to McDonald's, which is a healthy place to eat. We all love it, high in sodium, but they have good Diet Coke. But anyway, he would go to McDonald's and say, could I have a refill on my hamburger? And what would they say?
No.
So he goes, oh good, rejected, I can do this, it's okay. Then he went to a guy and knocked on a neighbor's door, not a neighbor, somebody he didn't know, and said, hey, can I play soccer in your backyard? Well, this guy said, yes. He goes, really? You don't even know me. He goes, yeah, you can. So he thought he had to do something else that day to get rejected. But he's blogging about this every day of 100 days of rejection. When he went on the airlines, he went to the stewardess and said, hey, can I make the announcements? I'm really good at it. And she said, yes. But his rejection, he did get rejected over and over again. The whole idea of the story is facing your greatest fear, like he did, which was rejection. He worked at it every day like a muscle. So if you have any fear here today, or you feel that it's going to be really hard, don't worry. It is going to be. But then you faced it, right? You can go home and talk about it. But it really is, I think it's really important that this guy, and of course he's older, but he's not as old as I am, but he just went for it and thought, so they say no to me, it's not going to be the end of the world. It's okay. And I do think sometimes with girls, and maybe not at this level, but when you guys get to this level or get to this level, sometimes that race, what if I put it all out there and I don't get what I want to get back from it? Do you guys ever feel that way? What if I give it 100% and it's lousy? Don't wait. Give it. Give it what you got that day. Give it everything you got that day. And face it every time you go. Don't try to say, well, this happened, and make excuses. Face it. Because it's going to make you better in the long run. Okay? So think of Jing. I won't say his last name like I said. Think of Jing. If you YouTube it, I just saw it. It's all over YouTube as well. But his blog is great. I think he talks on TED, but it's very funny, and he's very good. But face it. Don't be afraid to face. I mean, don't jump off a bridge to face your death or something. That's stupid. But you know what I'm saying? Okay? So today and every day we're going to break up. And again, if you... you can't do it. If you have an injury, don't tough it out. Come and tell me or tell your coach. It doesn't matter. We're not here to destroy you. You're here just to learn, you guys. That's all. This is a learning experience to get psyched up, to walk away and get so excited about what you're doing this season. That's what it's all about. That's all it's about. The other thing I really want you to encourage to do, because I know on my team, and I have a small team compared to some of you and a big team compared to some of you, on my team, we have about 400 kids. And when I bring my kids who are a main national team or a junior team or a national sled camp, whatever it is, I have them come back and talk to my little kids. And those little kids go, oh, like when Zoe comes and talks, she goes, oh, that's so exciting. This is so cool. How do I do it? And they get so excited. If you guys could share the story with the little ones, it is so exciting. So if you could ask your coach. And the little ones like to see the outfits you got, because that is all it. It's the gear, the water bottle, the backpack, the shirts, the caps. And tell them about, okay, the first day we had white caps. The next day we have Team Select caps. Tomorrow you don't know. Do you know what the caps are tomorrow? They're cool. But anyway, all right? You do get caps for tomorrow. All right. So really go back and share. Because you might not think you're cool stuff, but they look at you as like really cool stuff. We think you're cool stuff. Okay? So Richard did the warm-up today. He's going to explain the whole warm-up.